All right, so this is Final Fantasy X-2. This is the sequel to my favorite Final Fantasy, Final Fantasy X. And unfortunately, I never managed to get around to playing Final Fantasy X-2 to completion, so I thought it'd be a good time to make a Let's Play, and hopefully that will give me enough motivation to play from start to finish. This is one of those games where people either love it or hate it, but I'm sort of in between. I don't know what to feel about it. It's a lot of fun, there's a lot of dancing, a lot of cute girls, and a lot of cute outfits. The combat is different. It's more like Final Fantasy XIII, where it's like a real-time combat system. And yeah, it's a lot of fun boss fights. The story is not nearly as good as Final Fantasy X. It's kind of odd, to be honest. But let's just go ahead and hop in and see what you guys think. But this is probably going to be like a 35-hour game, so stay tuned for a lot of videos if I do manage to play it through completion, which I'm planning to. So this is the Blitzball Stadium. But this time we're not going to be playing Blitzball. Kind of a strange intro, I'll be honest. And honestly, Riku is super hot in this game. Compared to X, she got like a makeover, and her outfits are... oh, there's something else. So this is essentially a concert, and it's kind of funny. Like a rock concert. Yuna. Very, very long cutscene. And there's Pain. She's a new character. And I forgot to mention, this is the HD remastered version of Final Fantasy X. I'm playing it on PC. So from that intro, it's hard to tell like what this game is about. Kind of throws you off.
Boys.
Alright, so you may have noticed that Yuna's voice just changed, and we're fighting her for some odd reason. The reason is, and you'll find this out later, but she's actually an imposter, and she's using something called a dress sphere to steal Yuna's appearance. Ecstasy? She's came from ecstasy? Oh man, that's kind of funny. What's main commands? Escape, steal, swordplay. Let's see what swordplay is. Power break. I forgot what power break does. I'm pretty sure it lowers their like offensive power a little bit. But it also takes a while to cast. Let's try to steal something. I did say that this game was like Final Fantasy 13, but honestly, it's more like Final Fantasy 7. Just the way the gauges constantly fill up, and it's all about making quick decisions. If you're too slow, you end up losing turns.
I could have danced all night.
So that, of course, is not Yuna, and we're chasing after her.
Hold still.
And this game takes place after Final Fantasy X, so Yuna is extremely famous in this game, in all of Spira, the world. Let's steal some grenades. Phoenix down. Oh, I thought I could steal grenades. Let me see if there's anything this way. Nope. Oh well, getting some good experience, I suppose. There's a lot of fan service that goes on in this game too. Just look at Riku's outfit. Like a little mini skirt. You can see her thong and I don't know, she's like wearing like some sort of very skimpy bathing suit under her skirt. And Pain is like a gothic chick. I don't know where she came from. She came out of nowhere. I don't really understand where she came from at all. Alright, here's some new characters. Fire. I'm gonna try to steal from these guys. Maybe these guys. I know one of them. I thought one of these guys could drop grenades, but I may have been mistaken. It's been a long time since I played. I'm gonna go this way. I think there's something over here. It's getting very repetitive because all I can really do is press the A button. I don't have any other attacks at the moment besides Power Break and Steel. Stole a few Phoenix Downs and a couple High Potions. Not bad. I should move my mouse cursor out of the way. Ooh, look at that. Yep. A little hidden item there. A little hidden thing. That was a Moogle.
Move!
And I think that earns a small amount of percentage points for the story. And this game has kind of an odd way of handling the story. Basically, the more you do side quests, the more your percentage goes up. And depending on how high of story completion you've completed at the end determines the ending you get. So the ending's pretty much different every time you play, unless you're going for 100% completion. Which I'm not going to be doing.
You're too slow, little girl.
You really need a guide to complete it 100% through. There's a lot of stuff you have to do.
Show's over!
Youch.
This way.
And here's the real Riku. I mean, Yuna. The real Yuna. She has two pistols. kind of cool. Oh yeah, another thing new about this game, there's guns. I don't think there was any guns in Final Fantasy X, at least not from what I can remember. YRP. Yuna, Riku, Pain. Our battle has started. So I'm just gonna focus down one, there we go, and then I'll focus on the other.
Cannot be.
It's really funny to me that I'm shooting him with a gun. Oh, Yuna used to be like a summoner with like a staff. She was mainly like a healer. Like a priestess.
That's quite enough sniveling, boys. Persistent, aren't you?
My grid. You give us back Yuni's garment grid right now.
Didn't you girls ever learn to share?
Give it back.
So a garment grid
is yours.
Basically what you apply dress spheres to, I believe. And you need those to essentially improve your skill. Look at her outfit.
It won't be yours for long, loves.
Oh, man. Press LB to access the grid. We can switch. So you can switch dress spheres at any time while you're in combat. And different dress spheres give you different stats and give you different abilities. Darkness dance. So I just inflicted darkness on her. Let me switch to warrior with Riku. This will make this fight a little bit faster. Kind of reminds me of Sailor Moon, these little animations. So Yuna's just dancing, casting like a darkness spell. Well, that was really fast. I didn't expect it to be that fast.
I won't let you off so easily next time. Get back here! Riku. Huh?
What? Hey.
Yay. The real Yuna. Alright. Mission complete. Got some potions and leveled up. Sweet.
My body just started dancing by itself. I didn't know what was going on. I was frightened. Then, while I was dancing, something happened.
Something happened? Oops.
You sure looked like you were enjoying yourself.
I was. It felt like some other person's excitement just took over.
That can happen when you use their garment grid. The emotions of the person recorded in the sphere pass to the user.
Isn't that dangerous?
I can't really say.
But it's your invention.
I'm just a kid.
Dance, Yuna! I want to see!
It'll cost you.
One moment.
She's kidding.
What? Not dance? Look sick, Goblins! Doing kudiduk!
So if you haven't played Final Fantasy X, we are currently in an airship.
My latest invention.
Creature creator, use the fiend trap pods invented by Shinra. Shinra? To capture fiends all across Spira and train them all as ally creatures for the Gull Wings. The more fiends you capture and train, the more fascinating tales you will hear about them. Alright, so you can capture creatures. So what I was saying before, this is the airship, and these people are Riku's family. They're called the Elbed. And currently wondering if I should use a guide or not to like complete some things. I think I'm gonna try playing this game blind, and we'll get as far as we can without a guide. If I get stuck, I'll probably look things up.
It all began when I saw this sphere of you. At least, it looked like you. I couldn't say for sure. I thought I might find more spheres like it if I joined the Gullwings, so I did. Oh, in case you're wondering, the Gullwings are sphere hunters, and sphere hunters are, well... this. We fly all over Spira. I'm really enjoying myself.
Glad to hear it. For a while there, I was starting to feel like a kidnapper.
Don't be silly.
So what she's basically talking about is that she found a sphere of someone that looks like Tidus from Final Fantasy X, and of course Tidus is gone. He's essentially doesn't exist anymore. So now she's looking for these things called spheres that are like, they're sort of like recordings, like video recordings of things like, of people's, it's like video recordings basically, sort of like tape recorders that are just all over the place. So I guess we'll talk to this guy.
Still analyzing.
Buddy and brother are old friends. Buddy says he was aboard Sid's airship with us 2 years ago. When I told him I didn't remember, he seemed disappointed.
Scored an Elbed primer that lets me learn one letter in the
as a sphere hunter, and also as a friend.
In the Elbed alphabet.
I still don't know her very well. She's not exactly the talkative type. I heard she joined the Gullwings shortly before I did. Riku doesn't know much about her either.
What now?
So Pain is a pretty mysterious character. Apparently she was in the Gullwings before we even joined, so... yeah, who knows who she is. Very odd. Oops. I think I need to go down here and talk to
Yuna,
Buddy, or brother.
Is my talking gotten better?
He really has improved quite a bit. He told me that he practiced, just so that he could talk with me more.
Let's go! Party! Party!
What? You scored the Festivalist Dress Sphere? So I just earned a new class. Dress spheres are essentially classes in this game, and you can switch classes at any time. And I can go to the garment grid, and you can see... Yuna, Riku, and Pain are currently using this garment grid. Are you sure you want to rearrange the dress spheres? Yes. You can get different garment grids later on. Every day is a festival. Abilities vary by character. So I just equipped the festival garment grid dress sphere. So we got a new class, basically. Alright, so, can we go now? Who am I supposed to talk to? Oh wait, maybe I'm supposed to talk to that little kid who's over here.
I know everything.
Shinra's an Elbed. He's a real whiz kid.
Creature Crater. What is this? Yeah, let's just look at the tutorial. I have no idea. This is where you put captured fiends into teams and train them. Fiends are reincarnations of humans who couldn't make it to the far plane. My objective is to train fiends and learn the secrets of the fiend tale. Oh man. So I guess we're gonna go capture. Trap pod S has been supplied. I guess we're gonna go trap a creature. Set trap pods in areas that seem to be home of many fiends. Trap pods will cleanse the souls of fiends and turn them into good creatures. There are four trap pods? I don't remember this at all. Tracks fiends from all over, but trap pod SPs don't do the job. With trap pod SPs, you have to specify what fiend species you want to trap. Brother is a humanoid. You can round up trapped fiends using RB. Oh man, I don't want to do this. I'm pretty sure this is all optional. I don't remember doing this at all. Okay, so I am done with that. Oh, it's still going. Get me out of here. Wait, what is this saying? Select the creature you want to develop. And choose what you will use to develop the creature. For instance, if you select items, your item inventory will be displayed. The creature's status, you will see perimeter changes and added abilities that result from using the selected object. What the heck? So you can give your creatures that you catch items, and they learn new abilities. They can only learn 4 abilities, so it's kind of like Pokemon. Oh man, how do I get out of here? I don't think you have to do this. I think this is all optional. This is so long. Alright, get me out of this, please. When fiends grow, you can learn more about their fiend tail. If you go to the creature history, you can see a creature's fiend tail. When a fiend is unleashed, you can see its fiend tail ending. After viewing its fiend tail ending, the creature is added to the bestiary. Name creature, blah blah blah. Fiend arena. The fiend arena has various blah blah. By winning in tournaments, you can receive trap pods as rewards. Okay, that was so. That was such an overload of information, and it's still going. Get me out of here, please. I don't want to watch this. Get me out. Move the cursor to a team member on the right side of the screen. The selected team member will be switched out with a newly selected creature. Team member switch is now complete. However, keep in mind that creatures come in 3 sizes, small, medium, and large. Number of creatures that can be in battle team at any one time is restricted to 3S creatures. Put in size creature into the team. Ah. So I guess if you capture creatures, you can use them as your party. This sounds really strange. I don't know why you'd want to do this. I guess that's the reason for training creatures, is that you can use them on your team. But I mean, you have to replace one of your main members. I don't know why you'd want to do that. You can choose a dress sphere for it. This is so odd. This is so strange. God, this tutorial takes forever. Why did they add this at the beginning of the game? Ah, you can equip items to up too. Okay. Alright, I think I'm done. Please get me out of here. I could put on fast forward mode. Let me put on fast forward. Just to get out of this as fast as I can. It's so long. It's ridiculously long. Oh, okay. He gave me some trap pods for listening to this long tutorial. Oh god, that was hell. Can I get out of here now? Let's talk to Buddy. No. Alright, well, I think I've talked to everyone. I mean, I should try leaving, I guess. Oh, here's a save sphere. This is where I save. I feel like I haven't done anything. It's already been, like, 25 minutes into this video, which is insane to me. Okay, let's go somewhere else. I'm just gonna explore a little bit. I don't think I'm even supposed to go this way. Oh, there's a little bar.
Miss Yuna, what can-
Our barkeep's a Hypello. No one knows his real name, so everyone just calls him Barkeep. Brother took him in, and now he works aboard the airship.
The gold store. So here we can buy potions and stuff. I have 1500 so far. I can buy some equipment as well. I don't think I need to buy any of that. Let's see if there's anything upstairs. Maybe I do have to talk to everyone on the ship before I can proceed. Looks like there's some beds. I wonder if I can sleep up here. Well, actually, no. In Final Fantasy X, you replenish your health and MP at save spheres every time you touch one. There we go. So that's what I had to do. Oops. I did not mean to do that, but alright. I'm gonna take a screenshot of this. Well, let me get in a better position. My giant airship. Alright. So I did not mean to go all the way up there. Yeah, okay. Here we go. We're in the brig. In the engine room. Alright, let's talk.
Treasure sphere waves. They're coming from those ruins they found at Gagazet.
Alright.
Cut up! Gagazet!
Hot spot located, sphere hunt. So
Sacred Mount Gagazet, silent guardian of Xanarkand, city of the dead. When the faith disappeared, the clouds enshrouding the mountain began to thin and disperse, revealing long forgotten ruins among its peaks.
Hey, the rocks are floating! Don't tell me we gotta climb up that thing!
No worries. I'll take you to the top.
So throughout this entire game, we're basically hunting for spheres, and each time we go to a place, it counts as a mission. And those people we fought at the beginning, those like goons, they are sort of like Team Rocket from Pokemon. They will constantly appear and try to foil our plans. They are also sphere hunters, and they're trying to get like treasures and loot and become rich off of it. So we're constantly going to be, like, fighting them to get spheres.
What's your status?
Disasterific!
Oh, look at her butt.
Disasterific is not a word. Say disastrous, like the rest of Sphera.
I'm not listening.
Riku, come in.
You want me to hurt him?
That'd be great.
Coming!
Heave ho! Why would they drop us on a ledge so high in the air?
Thanks. That was a little close.
A little?
Coming!
We're here. Everything's fine now.
Yuna, keep an eye on Riku.
You got it.
Alright, so we're looking for a sphere. Press and hold B while approaching a chasm to loop across. Fail to press B and you may lose your balance. Be careful. Alright. Holding B as you approach a wall or a ledge will allow you to climb up. Certain places, not pressing B will allow you to jump down the ledge below. Got the treasure, a yellow ring. Let's go ahead and equip that. I have no idea what that is. Yellow ring. Halves lightning damage, user can cast thunder. Cool. How do I go up? Oh, there we go. It's not letting me jump across. Like, I'm pressing B. Uh-oh. There we go. That's weird. I was, like, tapping B really fast and wasn't registering.
Oh, we're not getting across this way.
Let's find another route.
Alright, let's save again. And I don't think I've mentioned this, but these videos are going to be an hour long each, since this game is ridiculously long.
Just great!
So feel free to skip through, and you may just want to see the boss fights.
Think this Machina still works?
Machina is basically code for machines. And in this world, machines are considered bad by certain groups of people.
I wonder how safe this is.
Looks like I may have missed a chest up there, but oh well.
What happened? Is Yuna okay?
Things are, oh, disasterific.
Disasterific? I am on my way.
I've learned from playing other Final Fantasy games that generally looking for loot, there's a lot of hidden loot in every Final Fantasy game, but generally speaking, even though it's very helpful, it can be very time consuming and often it's not even worth it. Why can't I jump? I guess you have to go back and then jump? There we go. I think this is the right way. I have no idea. Probably. Let me go back down though. I know I said I wasn't gonna look for loot, but I think there's some loot over here. An elixir. That'll fully heal my HP and MP of one character. I guess that's pretty good to have early on.
Turned on.
What? Turned on? That's kind of a weird thing to say. I wonder if there's something down here. Nope. I feel like every Final Fantasy game has so many like optional like areas to go with optional like loot to find. I mean, I just played through Final Fantasy VII not too long ago and I found so many items and I never ended up using like any of them. I had an inventory just filled with stuff.
LeBlanc! Remember that name well, loves.
LeBlanc.
Ah, the thief.
I thought that was her name,
whatever,
but I kind of forgot.
Mean? Ugh, that's what I hate about amateurs.
Maybe she'll go away if we ignore her.
You, I heard that. Just as I was saying, amateurs, they have no concept of what it takes to be a true sphere hunter.
Amateurs, weren't you following us?
Following? A mere coincidence.
You was right, boss, as always.
Indeed, following them has paid off splendidly.
Laugh while you can.
Fight number two. We're gonna be fighting these guys a lot, like 10 times or more. It's gonna be crazy. Alright, we inflicted darkness on all of them, so they shouldn't be hitting us too often. I'm just gonna focus on the big guy. I don't think it really matters.
Let me blow you a kiss. Stop your slacking this instant!
Love tap. I'm gonna do thunder. See how much damage it does.
One
1000. 28. Not too bad.
Let's get moving.
Not great either. Man, I'm missing them a lot. Why do I keep missing? I'm gonna switch Yuna's grid, and I wanna see what this, what the other grids are. I can't switch to the top grid because it's too far away. I should have put it a little lower. Oh well. She'll just be a warrior now. Oh. That's Tidus's blade.
Stand in my way, and I'll cut you down.
Woo. Level up, level up, level up.
Huh. And this is the thanks I get for going easy on you.
Hey,
does she think she is?
They do remind me a lot of Team Rocket. They kind of just appear, and they fight, and then they disappear, and then they fight you again later on. And now they're trying to race you to the top of the mountain to get the sphere. Outrun LeBronx Syndicate, beat the Syndicate to the top, but watch out, there's no telling what they'll do to stop you. Be the first to the top of the ruins. That's the objective. So I think you get like a bonus reward for beating them to the top. Although, I'm not going to be going too fast. Let's stop and get these treasure chests. Mega Phoenix. I want to see what this is. And every time you change classes, you get a different outfit. What the heck? What in the world?
Don't put off the party for another day. Do it now. No problem.
I need to look at what her attacks are. Garment grids, I think? No. Abilities, pain, festivalist. Okay, she can attack festivities. We'll learn spinner. Ah, okay, you can pick what skills you want to learn. Cure user status ailments and restore HP, twinkler. So this is something I kind of forgot, but... Ooh, trigger happy. But as you use each class, you learn new abilities, which is kind of cool, kind of interesting. Well, let's just keep going for now. Oops. I'm not really in a rush, but let's go ahead and see if we can't take some shortcuts. Is this even a shortcut? Or is this a dead end? Crap, I think that was a dead end. What is festivities? Blind mask?
I fight with style.
I think that did damage and it also inflict darkness. Such a weird character, and I'm missing a lot. I don't know why I'm missing every freaking hit. Oh, maybe I need to switch a character to the gunner class. Alright, I'm gonna switch Yuna back to gunner, and I'm gonna switch Pain back to Warrior. I think she's a better Warrior than all the other classes. Any way I can skip this? I think you can change it in the Options menu to not have to view these animations every single time, because they are quite long. I mean, they're kind of cool to watch, but after you watch them a certain number of times, it gets a bit ridiculous. I have never seen that dress sphere before. Maybe I just forgot to get it the last time I played.
Don't bother blocking.
There's a lot of optional dress spheres to find.
Effortless.
I can't believe this was like an... Was that seriously like... Can I not climb up? Why can't I climb up? I'm just wasting a bunch of time. Oh well. So I guess that was a dead end, which is kind of silly. Before I go any further, let me change garment grids. Oops. How do I dress spheres? There we go. No. Wait a minute. Yeah, let's put this one down here. back. How do I... Can I not switch their... Oh, here we go. I'm gonna make Yuna the gunner. Gunners can... They have high accuracy, and they can shoot down air targets. Just jump across. Okay. Bush. And Riku's still infected with darkness. I need to figure out how to get rid of that. I didn't know they carried over between battles.
Duck soup!
Duck what?
Duck soup? What the heck? Alright. That's, do I have any items? I have... Nope. I don't have anything to heal her, so... Forget about that.
You look a tad flushed. Why not stop to catch your breath?
Snakes! Trigger happy? Alright, so I have an ability with Yuna where... Well, basically what trigger happy is if you press the right bumper super fast, you can attack very quickly, but it doesn't do like a whole lot of damage. It just depends on how fast you can press a trigger. It's kind of repetitive, but oh well. Alright, let's try to catch up, I guess. I think I'm way behind, and the timer just keeps ticking down. I guess I can go right or this way. I don't know. We'll just go this way.
Sorry, boss.
Dolphins at your service.
Learn Flame Tongue. Swordplay Flame Tongue, deal fire damage to one enemy.
Turned on.
Oh, I got some eye drops. Okay, so let's use the eye drops. Cures darkness on Riku. There we go. And there's another box that we missed. We could have went around and got that, but oh well. What can you do? We're on a time limit. I really hate games that put you on a time limit. I'm the type who likes to slow down and enjoy myself. And find all the hidden items usually, but I think in this Let's Play, I'm just going to try as hard as I can just to get through the game as fast as I can. And later on, I'll have to train one of my characters as a white mage, I think, so that I'll have some curing abilities. But we'll see. I'll probably have to look up a guide to see how to defeat some of the bosses. Wait, how do I get up here? Is this even the right way? No! There we go. Round and around we go, round and around, round and around. Is this even the right way? Probably not. Dang it. What did we get? Crap, I didn't read that. Something, something, something. I hate these bombs. You hit them three times and then they explode. In like every Final Fantasy game, they're so annoying. I guess this one they don't explode too fast. Learn Pot Shot. Alright, I want to open my inventory again and see if I picked up something. I don't know. I'll have to rewatch the video later and see what I picked up. I mean, it could have been like a dress sphere. Nope. pretty sure it's not anything too important. And I don't know how to go up. Oh, I have to jump. I have to jump over here. There we go. The timer went away.
Would you stop staring?
These camera angles, they love to just show like a bottom shot, like looking up their like skirts and stuff. Alright, save here. Let's keep going up. Muscle belt. Oh, maybe we got like some equipment. Yeah, I think we may have found the star pendant from that last chest. Alright, so yellow ring has lightning damage. Raises strength and defense by 10. We're gonna give that to Pain. Choose a dress gear for brother. We can use brother as a character. I'm not going to. I'm gonna stick with Riku, Pain, and Yuna. What's the other accessory? Guards against poison. Let's just give that to Riku for now. One thing that's kind of unfortunate about this game is I don't believe there is any, there's not any weapons. Your dress spheres basically count as your, like, your armor, your equipment, and weapon, and abilities. So, I don't know. The game is kind of strange in that regard. It's sort of hard near the end of the game to improve the skill of your characters unless you have, like, high-level garment grids. Oh, and here's the first boss.
I didn't think we'd run into something like this.
It comes.
I'm gonna take a screenshot of it.
Can
I pause? Yeah, I'm gonna pause the game real quick. And I'm sorry to do this, but I just wanna see. Like, I want to look at a guide, and I want to see what this thing's weakness is. The Songstress Darkness Dance will come in handy here to reduce the overall damage you'll take from this boss. Assign one character to be the primary attacker, another for attacker healer, Riku or Yuna, and the other as Songstress support with Darkness Dance. Alright, so... Oops, I did not mean to do all that. Oops. So let's do Darkness Dance. Woo. I wonder if attacking with fire would do good in this. Like, flame torque, we'll try it. Sticky end. Let's keep doing Darkness Dance. How long does it take? Come on, Pain. Use your attack. Just standing there with her hand in the air. What you doing? Is she like trying to cast a spirit bomb?
You had your chance to run.
Flame tongue. That did 136, I think. I mean, I guess that was pretty good. And it just ate me. That was odd. And we killed it. That was an easy boss. I thought that boss was going to be a little bit more difficult. We found the treasure sphere. I believe it's the black mage dress sphere. Just looking at the guide.
It's obvious to the trained eye. That sphere's just a dud. Perfect for the Dull Wings.
You've wins again.
Well, I
so
guess
we're called the Gull Wings, this? And they just call us the Dull Wings. It's kind of funny. Woo! Mission completed. Got some fairy earrings and something else. And I think we found a new dress sphere. Let's equip that. To the garment grid. Oh wait, I thought that's what we found. What did we find? Or was that... That might not have been it. Oh wait, maybe it's our prize for successfully completing the mission. Hold on. Let's go back out, and let's go aboard the ship.
Brother! Mission complete!
Brother? He's not with you?
What happened to brother? Boom, 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 boom. We were supposed to get the Black Mage Dress Sphere. I may have just missed it.
He said something about Yuna being in trouble, then he just jumped ship.
And here he is.
He's alive, right? Just leave him there.
Can you analyze the sphere we found?
I'm pretty sure Riku and Yuna are like cousins. Or something like that. They're related somehow. Alright. Hold on a second. Garment grins. Dress spheres. Maybe we'll get it later. Oh my god, what the heck am I doing? This is such a weird position.
Thank you, brother.
I basically just teabagged him.
It was, it's nothing.
Don't strain yourself.
Leader must be tough.
Sicko!
I did find some other items though. I found some equipment. Go ahead and equip someone with something. Yeah, fairy earrings. Guards against confusion and berserk. Okay, we'll just give that to her. Grids. Alright. Let's talk to the little kid.
Analysis complete. Wanna watch the sphere?
Ah, so this is what we found. Like I said, some of the spheres have recordings. And there is Xanarkand, Tidus' hometown. If you don't know who Tidus is, in Final Fantasy X, he was the main character, and he was basically like Yuna's boyfriend.
I can't believe I actually got a ticket. What a thrill to be able to shake her hand.
But he essentially died at the end of Final Fantasy X, so...
Think it's worth
well,
anything?
Not really died, but disappeared.
It's not very exciting.
Junk.
But we can use it as a dress sphere.
Hooray, we got the Black Mage Dress Sphere. I was wondering when we would get that. And the guide just says, after you beat the boss, you'll get it.
To your stations. How long you plan on lying there?
What is it?
The treasure sphere data you've been dying for. There's at least one on Besaid Island. And another in the Xanarkand Ruins.
So, where to?
Aboard the airship, the sky's the limit. Based on the information Buddy collects, you can travel to various hotspots, take on missions, and advance the story. So we found some new hotspots. Before you leave, let me tell you about mission select menu, blah 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 blah. Easy, hard. how hard each area is, blah, 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 blah. So basically it opens up and you can travel essentially anywhere now. Later on, there'll be a lot of hotspots and a lot of side quests that you can do in each hotspot. So yeah, I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to save here, and I'm probably in the first episode of this little Let's Play. Hopefully you enjoyed. I know it probably wasn't like that enjoyable to watch me do that horrible tutorial that was so long. But other than that, you know, it's a cheerful game. It's supposed to be sort of like lighthearted and a little bit more uplifting than Final Fantasy X. Final Fantasy X was pretty dark, and there was a lot of, throughout most of the game, it was pretty dark. A lot of death, and the sin was basically killing everyone, and there was, like, no hope. In this game, it's basically afterwards, and you defeated sin, and the world has been saved, pretty much. And everyone's all cheerful and happy, and, yeah, it's just a fun little game, and we're looking for, we're kind of just looking for evidence to see if Tidus is still alive, or if we can't find him again somewhere. At the end of Final Fantasy X, he was essentially created by the Faith, I think that's what they were called. And the Faith are like spirits, I don't know. It's way too hard to explain. But after we defeated Sin, he basically returned to the Far Plane, which is where all the spirits go. And he basically doesn't really exist anymore. Or if he does, he's in the Far Plane somewhere. But he was never really real to begin with. He was sort of created by the Faith. So, I don't know. It's a very, very odd story. And I'm going to stop rambling now. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for part two. And we'll try to make some good progress in the next episode. But yeah, thanks for watching. Have a nice day.